Viewers, Super GT here. How are you all doing? Another week, another opportunity to get binned into the Shadow Realm. Right, let's get straight into it, shall we? Three interesting races. Brands Hatch Indy in a one make classic Porsche. Group 3 at Le Mans, aka Lemons, obviously. That's the proper way to say it. And race C this week is Autopolis in the Super Formula car. So, we're going to kick it off, as we always do, in race B. Now, the good thing about this is that if you look here, Thomas has gone number one now. It's a fair mix of different cars. How many different cars? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 different cars in the top 10 at the moment. That's very good. We almost never get that. Almost never get that. Do you think you look like Alexander Albon? It's not too far away, actually. I've been told by many people I look like Alex Albon. He's half English, half Thai. I'm half English, half Filipino. So it's not too different, I suppose. Matt Foster I'm spacking the lift here for you, pig, so you get food. Spacking the lift here, man. I miss Asim. He's a good lad. Taken to the realm far too soon. Right. I've done lots of practice in the Mustang, so I'm gonna use the Mustang to begin with, but this is a race we can do a couple of times over at least. Use different cars. So I was thinking we could use GTR once, the Ford GT, the Supra should be good. The McLaren F1 GTR, the Huracan possibility. Just trying to think. Top end cars. The Atenza might be alright. McLaren. But I mean there's like 6-7 cars that you could use here. And Calster firing in the Lamborghini suggestion, of course. He basically lives in a Lamborghini. I can imagine Calster, like, let's say Calster won 200,000 on the lottery. He could buy a house, or he could buy a Lamborghini Huracan. He would just live in the, just buy the Huracan and live inside it. The old Merc. Look at that thing. Look at it. Just lurking there. The unloved Mercedes. No one likes that thing. It's all about the AMG. Well, I'm gonna pop into the old must. Oh, okay, yeah. Yesterday's stream. It got let me bring up on Twitter. It got claimed by supercars. So like the V8 supercars, this, you know, the Australian series. So they claimed it. Come on. Your video has been blocked. Wait, I see that. So for about, how long is that? Not 54 seconds. In the middle of the race, they went, yeah, that's a match. I don't know why just that 54 seconds. Thank you, Ed Munoz. Thank you very much, mate. So that video, that stream got claimed. I'm gonna try to dispute it. Well, I already have. Pretty much every time I've got copyrighted, I've always disputed it, and I've always got it overturned every time. It's always wrong. They need to add your car to this game. They do have an Abarth. Wait, what one do they have? My car is in Forza 7, but it's not in this game. Thank you, Matt Foster. But yeah, so you better watch that soon when that claim gets released. It's really weird. I guess it, because it's an onboard, it must have matched some sort of supercars content where they went on board with a car for a while. It just looks exactly the same. It turns out that the lap times that we were doing yesterday were pretty similar to what V8 supercars do. But so if you look at the bottom left there, it says visual content, 47 minutes, 54 to 48, 48. So it's like just under a minute. And I watched that bit. It's just me, just part of the race. Just me going around the track as normal. So I don't know. Who knows? YouTube algorithm doing it, doing bits once again. Right. Let's try and fire in a quick lap here. I've gone for the Bentley livery. Which actually looks freaking amazing, even though it's not a Bentley. You mad livery purists, deal with it. And I've gone for the Mazda 787B socks today, around, of course, Le Mans, where it has a 100% strike rate. Preston Adams, you change your name to R4M, man. Good stuff. The R4M crew grows stronger. We've only, honestly, there's probably about 30 or 40 people in R4M now. It's a big squad we've got. We're going to take over the world. So I'm going to hopefully emulate Mazda and get a 100% strike rate today, which probably won't happen. What kind of rig is he using? This frame here is the Simlab P1. Thomas Warwick, welcome to the Shadow Realm. Let me whack on those sounds. Thank you, Thomas Warwick. I've absolutely bottled this lap. So it's a weird race. It's a really weird race, this, because there's so much straight line. There's so much straight line. There's a lot of slipstreaming. If you get out of the slipstream range, like, you really lose that. You lose out quite a lot. R4M Asim's cousin. You thought Asim was bad enough. Wait for his cousin in R4M form. R4M's going to take over the world, I think. Thank you, Elias. There's no such thing as a free lunch. You should have seen some of the lunges last night. Pretty mega lunges in there. It's an entertaining race. Thank you, Elias, for the sex. I was just running out of that. I needed a bit more. Right. I think the next corner coming up, for me, is the hardest one to get right on the whole track. I still can't quite judge the braking point for it. Car just didn't really want to go in. The track limits here, yeah, they're definitely a bit funky. You can push them in places, but you do have to be careful. And if you do get a penalty, it really kills your race. Then we all knew that. Rubbish lap. Yay. Trip ends. I know I did a 56.5, that's my fastest, but I know I can do 55 at least. Taking that awfully. Penalty! As well. Okay. What TCS do I use? Normally, almost always zero. Now, the only time I ever use TCS is sometimes at the start of a race, off of a grid start. But that's about it. Oh, okay, there we go. We got Wi-Fi password in the house. There he is. First on the grid. Pole position. So what have we got? We got a mix of cars. I like that. I always like a race where there's a mix. We've got a couple of Mustangs, a couple of four GTs, couple of GTRs, got a Supra, and a couple of McLarens. There is a Huracan in there as well.
Anyway, look. So I went on the internet this week and we'll found this.
Thank you, Alexandra Coat, becoming a member. Thank you very much. And for the donation there of the $10. Thank you very much.
Honestly, what the f*** are we doing here?
Welcome to the Shadow Realm, my friend. Why don't you do rally races? Normally, in an open lobby, I always do. But they never come up in daily races. I don't I don't recall there's ever been one. They did one in the World Finals for the Repecharge race, which was very interesting. It was an absolute rammer fest. But I don't think they've ever done one in daily racing. I can't remember one anyway. Why is no one using the Evo? The Evo is so slow in a straight line. Like, you might as well just be in group four. It's that bad. He's... Oh, 4M Matt Foster's rabbit. How's the old rabbit going, mate? Has he joined R4M, I guess? But yeah, the Evo isn't good in a line. It's very bad. So it's just not worth using. I think the key in this race is going to be working together in the slipstream. Just make sure you don't fight too much too early. Oh, that guy spun. Don't fight too much too early so that the guy ahead gets out of slipstream range. Then you mess it right up. You don't want to do that. Okay, here we go. Evo so planted through the chicanes and S's. Yeah, but it's just, there's just not enough of them. You might gain half a second through the S's with the Porsche curves, but then you'll lose 3 seconds on the straights. It's just not worth it. It's all about straight line speed here. That's the name of the game around Lemons.
Get it, right, Lewis.
Miracle chicane start here is an absolute nightmare. Whenever you've got a rolling start on a chicane, it's a nightmare. And this track's got like two right at the end. It messes everyone up. There's going to be best... I'm just trying to think of the best position to start. I think I've got the worst of it here. Yeah. See, the grid splits apart so quickly. I'm already 9 tenths behind. I'm out of slipstream range already. So I got back into it now. Find the Bulgarian. That's not a penalty, it might be. It's too wide. It's no stream though, so it's alright. But look at that. Gap to second is huge already. Make your mind up. We just need to catch up. I don't care what you do. Let's just catch up together. What's about the slipstream range? I can't quite go past. I think the Ford GT is... Oh, no, wait, I am going past now. I think the Ford GT should be the quicker car in a straight line. Past, I'm not gonna fight him.
Well, I always want to start.
Thank you, Matt Foster.
Thank you to all this crowd. I mean, you guys have been amazing.
Neck and neck here. Shows you, as soon as you lose that slipstream, you're struggling. Good drag race this. Ah, God's sake. Okay, well, we better get used to it because we're going to get more of them throughout the day. Okay, the next zone is just coming into the final chicane, so you don't lose too much time there because you need to slow down anyway. So yeah, I'm driving the Ford Mustang in Group 3, for anyone wondering. He's got a big penalty there. Wi-Fi Pastor is driving really well, but we can get second. And I was lucky to not lose the position for that penalty. I don't know where the next penalty zone is. There's two on the track. IIRC. Everyone's getting penalties. Still there. Car right. I've got the bad brakes though. Come on, Wi-Fi Buzz, I'm going for you, mate. Oh, we just lost 2 tenths on that chicane. See ya! Oh, there's three. There's 3 penalty zones then, I think. Gap's coming down, 1.5.
I think Eric's in Inniss.
Come on, Wi-Fi password. Do something silly, mate. Ah, penalty. That's the thing, it's hard around here because you've got so much tarmac on the sides, but you can't really use it. You can use it a little bit, but not too much. Oh, he's gone wide. I'm in the slipstream. Oh, and he's got a penalty. Come on. It's a neck and neck race now. Come here. Oh mate, look at that speed. Who's gonna blink first? Right, I'm in the lead. Penalty zone is here. That guy in third, how's he doing? Is he catching up with us? No, we should be alright. Come on! Get that Mazda 787B 100% strike rate. What's he done? Oh, he's binned himself. Wi-Fi, what are you doing, man? He's dropped down. Where's he gonna finish? Eighth. Oh my god. He was second. There we go. I'm just gonna quit the stream now. 100% win rate. That's it. Thank you, Shane O, for the £2. Mate, 100% win rate. Get in there, Lewis. Miracles do happen, mate. Do happen, mate. Konomi, thank you for motivating me to finally get all stars in Drive Club. My first... couldn't quite finish that. I'm guessing your first platinum thing. Thank you. No worries, man. Whoa. I still need to get back on my game. Yeah. Yo, HyperJrive, how you doing? Good to see you, mate. What a race. What a race. I'll take that. I'll take a win.
Felipe, baby, stay
Wi-Fi
cool.
Password.
We're bringing you the white visor. Stay cool. We're in a good position.
Boom. Job done. R4M. Takeover. Continues. David Marquez. Thank you.
I think Ericsson hit us.
Not sick. Yeah, not quite. I will be sick for some point today. Thank you, Sammy, as well. Thank you, Matt Foster.
Get in there, Lewis. Miracles do happen, mate.
Yep, it's the socks, man. That's what it's all about. Buy yourself the Mazda 787B socks. You just win every race. Guaranteed. But then what if two people are wearing it? Then what happens? I don't know. Right, race C now. Super Formula car. Autopolis. I haven't done the race, so I'm not sure on strategy. I'm guessing one stop, medium to medium. I don't think you can. I think you're going to use mediums anyway. But maybe a bit of fuel saving. Maybe going down to leaner settings through the final sector, possibly. I don't know. We'll have to work that one out. Does anyone know the man behind the name? The Wi-Fi password guy? If that's who you're talking about. Apparently he was at... he's been to some of the events, so... people have met him, yeah. What does the radio man say, Philippe? He says, Felipe, baby, stay cool, we're in a good position. It was, if you type in Felipe Mass... Philippe, just type in Felipe, baby, stay cool on, YouTube. It was in Malaysia 2009. It was getting really wet and really misty, they couldn't see. And Felipe Massa wanted the clear visor instead of the dark one so he could see better in the rain. And then his engineer was, Felipe baby, stay cool, we're in a good position. So just this baby thing came out. So qualifying too bad. But we'll definitely go a bit quicker than that. It's one stop. You don't have to feel safe, but would recommend a little bit. Yeah, okay. I'd imagine that... well, you'll see in tomorrow's video, actually. So the FIA race on Saturday was really interesting. It was 11 laps of Catalunya, and I went for... a really weird strategy, really weird, shouldn't have worked, shouldn't work, but you'll see. Does he know he's the Wi-Fi password? Yes, he does, actually. He sent me a message earlier. I really like your Wi-Fi password jokes. He sent me a friend request today, actually. But he's fully aware of the joke. Right, let's do a quick lap before we begin. never get that first corner quite right in this car. It's so quick, you have to get it right to the millimetre. I've been hearing that this car is easier on the controller, actually. I have to go back to the controller. If you look at the top two times, Calster and Thomas, I'm pretty sure they both use a controller. And they're like four tenths ahead of third place. It feels really weird driving this track in this car again, because the last time we were here was in Group 4. So to come back at this speed is just... it feels really strange. So much less time to react.
There's a giant lizard on the track.
Millions are watching. Not quite millions, but... I'll still try not to slip. What's the most you've ever seen someone get on a live stream on YouTube? I mean, I know that... like, Joe Rogan experienced, guess what, like 45,000 people watching at one, in one go? Just PewDiePie streamed, hasn't he? You guess, he must get what, like 100,000? I don't know what the highest is, but I'm guessing around about 100,000. KSI versus Logan Paul fight would have got a lot. Wait, didn't they get like 800,000 or something? Or like a million? Didn't they get like a million viewers actually? Calster versus KSI. Oh, that's a fight I want to see. Right, we're starting fifth. Okay. A lot of work to do if I want to keep up my 100% strike rate. Yeah, let's start some beef between Calster and KSI, or Logan Paul. Or Calster versus James Charles. This makeup kid who's been in the news recently. Ninja's had 667,000 on Twitch. That's just crazy, isn't it? 600,000. Two-thirds of a million people. That is insane. You think, like, that's rivaling just, like, TV shows? Or something like... I don't know, just some standard TV show during the day get like that. That amount or less. But yeah, I mean it's insane really, isn't it? But it shows you that this is the new way, this is what
your young generation like, don't they? They like watching the internet. They're not really fans of watching the TV anymore.
That was my condescending old person accent. Oh, that was a great warm-up. Right, here we go. Hello. Throw in a quick hello. It was also a bit northern, yeah. Northern old person accent. Don't know why I went northern. Got a McLaren on pole. Kimi Raikkonen's playing, he's in 13th. Nice. Oh, on my ribbon. Don't do that. Oh, he's got Ferrari livery. He's going to bottle it. Oh, thank you very much. Oh my god. Right, game ruined. That's it, I'm burning this game. What the hell did I even do there? Tell me what I did there. Rip-a-roni. Explain that one, atheist. Well, that's my race ruined. How many positions will I lose? Come on, go, 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 go. Oh my god, that went on forever. That's right, slow down. Let me back in sixth, obviously. Had to be sixth. We're going to have to save that replay and analyse what the hell the game was thinking.
I think it looks like this.
I don't think I've mapped my... I haven't mapped my overtake button. God, the grip loss is unreal when you're behind someone. You have to be patient now, I think. Very hard to overtake. Try it, but couldn't quite get past. Here we go. Don't have overtake button though, annoyingly. Thank you, Matt Foster, once again, mate. Matt Foster loves it, doesn't he? First place, long way away already. Living life on the edge. brave enough. No grip when you're that close. Well, obviously you get some, but a lot less. Take that. Right, when are people going to start pitting? I'm guessing lap 6. Cheeky brake adjustment halfway through the turn. Not the best place to do it. Back to third.
Get in there, Lewis. Miracles do happen, mate.
Thank you, Sammy. A Horizon 4 video. We're long overdue one of those, aren't we? I'll have to take a look. I actually watched one of them back, and I don't know, they're just hilarious.
Miracles do happen, mate.
Thank you, Naveek. I'm worried about coming out in traffic. Big group, about 15 seconds behind me. Continues. See what second place does. He goes on, I'll carry on as well then. One more lap of fuel.
Thank you.
Tommy's coming with 12%. He's done well on fuel saving. I've only got 5.
Honestly, what the f*** are we doing here?
Scratch Echo's done well as well, actually. I need to improve that. Thank you, Bill. Kind of bad FFB settings, mate. I mean, you just want the settings that make you feel comfortable. And if you're not comfortable, then you're going to be slower. So, yes. Thank you very much, Bill. Relapse, let's see. I'll do. Have to fuel save a little bit. I'm guessing into this section you can go down. This bit doesn't need so much power. So I think I was quicker than Scratch Echo, but he was fuel saving, so... Well, he's fuel saving more than I was, so... I don't know if I was genuinely quicker. To get past, but whoa, where is he? I'm cleanly into second now. Second, I'll take that, especially after that stupid penalty at the beginning.
And his name is
Super GT.
Thank you, Glidden Voss, Matt, for 27 quid. Thank you so much, man. Thanks for tuning in.
think I'm just saving enough. It's my, oh, what's happened there? They've made a big mistake behind. My pace has been similar to Tommy in the lead. Similar, not quite on him, but... So the overtake button, I need to map it. I haven't mapped it to my, on this wheel. So I've had that disadvantage, I suppose. Oh god. Although it uses more fuel, so... Overall, you don't want to... It's not always a good idea to actually use it. I think the best time to use it is just off the start to secure a good position. Sometimes just to use it to genuinely overtake so you don't lose too much time stuck behind someone.
Felipe, baby, stay cool. We're bringing you the white visor. Stay cool. We're in a good position.
Cheers, Matt Foster. Scared to go on a throttle coming out of there as well.
Anyway, look, I went on the internet this week and I found this.
Jerry Bibble, thanks for becoming a member. Good evening, Skyline. Or morning, I don't know what. Good morning now in the Philippines.
Saying big thank you to all this crowd. I mean, you guys have been amazing.
What's the livery? I'm using the Ford's EcoBoost livery. Loads of spam memes on the front wing, on the front.
Super GT.
Anyway, look, I went on the internet.
Devil
Z has
also become a member. Thank you. Lapping someone in. This guy was... Wait, I thought he started ahead of me on the grid. What's he... What happened to him?
I always want to start by saying big thank you to all this crowd. I mean, you guys have been amazing.
So Tommy's won that race. Well played. Come for into second. Piper Blue, thank you. What's my favourite race on the calendar? And do I think Williams will score a point? Even though they are by miles the slowest car. Well, yeah, it's hard to say. I mean, if they do, it's because of lots of retirements for other cars or something. They are so far off. So probably not, unless something really drastic happens during the race and eight cars get wiped out or something. Favourite F1 race in the calendar?
Interlagos, I'd say, because it normally just, it's normally near the end, it can decide championships, and it's normally just a very good race. I'll say that one. Find the overtake button, yes, I'll do that. And we'll look at the replay. So that was an okay race, I suppose. You see, have a look at the livery there. What is better, the Toyota or the Honda? They are exactly the same, apart from one's a Toyota and one's a Honda. They make a slightly different sound. The Toyota's a bit louder. But here, I think you can only use the Toyota anyway. So everyone's in exactly the same car. They are the same, though, performance-wise. It's annoying, yeah, because I had the Honda. I didn't have the Toyota, so I had to buy it. And I don't have many credits on this account, so it's quite annoying. I don't see why they don't just let you use two, but... where it is. Let's... well, I'll map that button, and I'll have a look at the replay. I'm pretty sure I thought I did map it on this account, but... Xbox button, so it's really confusing. First change view that hazard lights. What do I do? Overtake. Now let's have a look at that replay. See how I got that stupid penalty. I have honestly no idea what happened. I'm guessing I touched someone and then that person went off. But we shall take a look. I missed a donation. Did I? Oh, Sean Washington. Sorry. Let me just take a look at what you said. How many bags of discos do you have left? Like 12 or something. I'll be honest, I've gone through quite a lot of that box. I've gone through it very quickly. Thank you, Sean. But yeah, I mean, I have a problem. When it comes to like Pringles or something, if the thing is open, I'll just go through it. Like, if there's something there, I'll just eat the whole thing or like a lot of it. For example, like if I were to buy like a 6-pack multi-pack of crisps, right, I'll have one a day. I'll have like 4 on the first day and then the other 2 the next day. It's not pretty. Is the John Cena clip still there? I changed it. I changed it to a Kimi Raikkonen thing. It's actually really annoying me now. That John Cena thing, because I changed it. I 100% changed it. Oh. Well, that's what... I can't even see why I got that penalty, to be honest. I'm guessing that Ferrari just clipped me on the way off. John Cena's still there. Let me just take a look on my dashboard quick. I 100% turned it off. Yeah, it's not there. I don't get it. I turned it off. I changed it. Unless it's on donations. No, it's not there either. Donation, not a super chat. Yeah, because it is different. Okay, I'll have a look at it next time or after this. But I specifically got rid of it. It's still coming up. Once you go John Cena, you can't go back. That's the fact. So wait, will I actually time now? I won't even be able, I'm gonna miss the race. Oh well. So that hasn't happened in ages, but I don't know what's going on. Okay, what car should I use for the next Group 3 race at Lemons?
Okay, I had a look on the internet and this was on it. Whoa!
Thank you, Naveek.
Changed again. Top time
has changed. McLaren F1 goes to the top now. John Cena's time is always now. You can't change it. Yeah, that is true. He lives in the present. Cannot be changed. So it's a weird mix. The Huracan does have, yeah, it does have good top end actually, but you have to be really good out of the turns. Jag's a good shout actually, because I think that's got top end. The Renault, oh god. Aston Martin, yeah, that's a good. I think that's a decent car around here. Obviously, it's not on the leaderboard, but I think it is still okay. Dodge Viper, mate. I'm gonna use the GTR. I think. I want to check. I do want to watch that replay again before we got a few minutes. I want to see if it works. Go for it very quickly. Yeah, there's no R8 in there. The R8 is really good around like just like medium speed corners, and it's just not the thing about Le Mans. It's dominated by straights. So no matter, even though you've got the Porsche curves and chicanes, it's just so much straight. You're spending like out of the 3.5 minutes lap, you're spending like 2.5 minutes on a straight. Yeah, this is annoying as well. On these replays, you have to watch this start bit. On FIA races, what's the whole grid thing? It takes ages. There's a Ferrari. This guy, I think. Oh, shouldn't have done it. Shouldn't have pressed anything. Okay, we'll forget that. Forget that replay. Forget about it. It was a stupid penalty. We don't need to see it again. They put the intro in the replays, yeah, and it's really annoying. Ripperoni! Once the replay's bugged, it's bugged. I think all you can do is pause it. You can pause it and that's it. Can't fast forward or rewind. Do a face reveal. Who do you think I am? Okay, here's a face reveal. Bloody hell. I'm actually wearing a mask, so not even a face reveal. Yeah, Gran Turismo doesn't want me to see it. Top 10 things they don't want you to see. Gran Turismo Sport. Those penalties have been getting worse and worse recently, I think. Right, let's have a look. Two laps of Lemons. I'm going to go for the GTR this time. But, I mean, we can do this race lots of times, so. That's why, like, if race B is good, I'm happy, because you can do it over and over quite quickly. 3 an hour, to be precise. When did I start using a wheel? January, so not too long ago. But yeah, I like it. It's good. It's I've got better at this game, believe it or not. I've got better at this game.
since using the wheel. It's just a nicer experience. Would you pay for DLC? I would, but I mean, they're bringing it out for free, so I'd rather they just kept it free. Free is always good. Okay, that explains it, because I didn't have the space. That explains why the penalty was bugged. No, that replay. Right, let's have a quick look then at the GTR. This big boy. I used to drive this thing all the time. Oh god. Right, let me do that again. Super GT would make an excellent trans woman. Well, there's something you should know. I already am a trans woman. So bulky. Oh, that's some Gran Turismo 3 flashbacks right there. Are you an Albon brothers? Yes. No, he's actually my dad. Believe it or not. Crazy, isn't it? Top 10 things you would not expect from Formula One. Ugh. Super TT's dad is James Charles. James Charles. I mean, I'd never heard of him until all this beef came out. To be honest, I still don't even care. I couldn't give any less of a shit about him. Not that I hate him, but he's just... I have no interest. Who is he? He's some makeup artist. He has... Well, he did have 16 million subscribers, he's gone down about 3 million now. Jeff Flynn, use a Tesco value livery on the Huracan. Livery on the Huracan. I'll donate £10. I mean, that'll be the easiest £10 I've ever made in my life, I think. Thank you, Jeff Flynn. Tesco value. Imagine actually doing that, buying a Huracan and putting Tesco value on the side of it. But yeah, James Charles, I mean, he's lost like 2 million subs in the last like 2 days, or last week. There's some pretty funny jokes going around. Like, is there, like, because he's lost like a million subs in like a day, he should get like a gold play button for like minus subs. You get a gold play button for getting a million subs. What if you lose a million subs? You get some weird inverted gold plaque. And soon he'll be on 10 mil, so he'll go back. And he'll have to hand back his diamond play button. Congratulations on reaching 10 mil. Oh, sorry, you're going to have to hand that back now because you've gone back underneath. Sorry. Oh my god, it's so clunky through here. And our penalty. This is a big boy. Very big boy.
He's lost 3.1 minutes so far. Jesus. I mean, I don't even know what he's done. I don't even know what he did. Or what he supposedly has done. I haven't even paid attention to it. There's probably a PewDiePie video on it by now. I'll have a look later.
Honestly, what the f*** are we doing here?
It's weird to think that PewDiePie will be on 100 mil soon, or the T-Series will be on 100 mil soon, and then... Matt Foster! Your dad is the Stig, and Guy Martin, and Ken Block, and Nigel Farage combined. Nigel Farage? Like, I'm not going to lie here, but that's actually true. I don't know how you know that, but... I'll show you the best line for this chicane. This is how you take it, okay? See? Really quick. Works every time. 0% of the time. Right, here we go. Oh my god. Even Bokomomos is up there. There's like a French block, third to sixth. Good luck getting through that. You dirty Brit. We will not let you through. Don't forget to pray to Slipstream. That's my religion, man. That is my religion. Every straight, gotta pray to him. Never watched PewDiePie. Is he on Gran Turismo as well? Imagine if PewDiePie made a Gran Turismo sport video. Like, what? I'd love that.
Felipe, baby, stay cool. We're bringing you the white visor.
He gave
cool.
Super
GT
a big fat shout out. Peter McKay just went full send with $1. Thank you very much, Peter. I'm going to win this race just for you, Peter. You watch. Especially whether or not to go to the Le Mans 24 Hour this year. I might actually go. It's a bit late now. Hotels are probably costing £1 million, but could drive down there. Might give it a go. Is anyone going? I don't know. Thoughts on the Spanish GP? Rubbish. I mean,
Felipe, baby, stay cool. We're bringing you the white visor. Stay cool. We're in a good position.
Thank you. Pray to ask him and Wi-Fi password. Here's my thoughts on the Spanish Grand Prix. Solid meme, that. Solid meme. Right, here we go. There's some pretty decent hotels still available. Okay, I'll have a look. Do you watch 1320 videos? I don't. I'll have a look at that later. Starting the chicane again. That's alright, it's not too bad. Oh god, almost killed myself instantly. Insta-kill. Look at that, 7.5 seconds away from the lead already. It's too big, it's too much. I'm in that slipstream. I don't think I am. Well, that's me dead for this entire straight. Nothing I can do. This guy is gonna go past me now. Maybe.
Well, I always want to start by saying a big thank you to this crowd. I mean, you guys have been amazing.
This is a big tasty group up ahead, but I can't get in. I'll get in there. Thank you, Tokyo, for the £2. Oh, this is the problem, like, you lose the slipstream and that's it. You are dead. Guys gonna come past me.
Anyway, look.
Maybe we need to do that to let go. Thank you, Glenn Boss. You can keep slingshotting past each other. So I think if there's one tip to success in this race, it's just qualify well, because the field spread is just so big. Just keep slingshotting past each other, hopefully gain a little bit that way. Come on, slipstream! Yes, I think I'm in it now. We have potential to do something. Now, everyone just get a penalty, please. The hell? Oh my god. I thought the curb messed me up, but I think he hit me. He must have hit me. The curb wouldn't have done that. Thanks for messing both of our races up. I can't win the race for Peter now. Pizza once again.
King in the castle, king in the castle. Have a chair, I have a chair.
There's stuff still going on here, so see what happens. Yeah, I think Ericsson hit me again. Momo's with the 0.5. Oh yeah, that's it, Aston Martin. Give me that slipstream, baby. I love it when you do that to me. Keep it in. Okay, two of them got penalties there. Should. Let's get past both of them. Zombies! What a gift card that is, man. Yeah, I mean, the gift cards, most of them are just always junk. You can't sell them, which is an annoying thing.
I always want to start by saying big
yellow flag.
Looks
like someone.
I mean, you guys have been amazing.
I'm up into ninth, so someone's just gone off there. Thank you, John Bees. Okay, shoot. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. I hope not. No, not quite. Okay, we're up to seventh. Wi-Fi Pass was winning the race. What a legend. Let's qualify better. I reckon we can still get fifth here. Fifth is still possible. Tap. Oh my god. That's annoying now because now it's just in my slipstream. Now it can get back past me. So it was an accident, but now we can gain out of it. He's going to bump drive me. Okay, I'll take that then. Favour repaid. And didn't hit us that time. Penalty! Give him a penalty! Oh, mate. I felt like I had speed there. I just... I don't know, I just couldn't quite do anything. Frustrating race, that one. Thank you, Naveek, once again, mate. Press the accelerator a bit hard. Ah, you should have told me at the start of the race, man. Then I would have won. I think the problem with that race, daily race B, is just the grid start, or not the grid start, the rolling start is just too split. Needs to be a bit closer. If they could do an actual Le Mans start where you do a rolling start 2x2, that'd be amazing. So it'd be an absolute mess. Still, gain three positions. Always good to go up. I'll take that. Well, I won't really, but...
Honestly!
So am I, mate. What to use next? A Corvette in second. Yeah. Use the McLaren next. Mr. Knifarino is watching for the first time. Welcome along to the stream, mate. Wait, let me, I forget, I'm going to delete a load of old replays because I haven't got any space. What am I doing? Replays. Space up in here.
Cockpit cam or riot? Well, riot it is then. Get that a lot in videos recently. You know, you'd be better if you used cockpit view. I think cockpit view is better. Good for you, mate. I don't think it's better. So, you do what you want to do. I'll do what I want to do. How about that? Click the Lambo on what I'm subscribing. Let me find this Tesco livery then. I'm not going to use the Lambo, not yet anyway. I honestly hate the Lambo. It's a crime against motorsport to use that thing. I need to finding a needle in haystack, really, isn't it? In this. No. I'll look later. Do I hate the Lambo because of Calster? I hate it because it's an awful car. Which handles like... It just handles really weird. Right. 4GT. Oh man, this car's a blast from the past. Here we go then. What about a Lidl livery? No one wants to make it, I'll use it. Win this for James Charles. I'm going to save his career by winning this next race. Watch. Alpha 4C, surely good for Le Mans. I might as well use the slow script 4 car, that'd be quicker than that. I haven't used this car yet, so ECS on. So we use heavy wets, I reckon. It might rain halfway through, you never know. Never know. They might do a wet weather update halfway through the race, and then I'll just walk to victory. You never quite know. Right, here we go then. 4GT spec car. This thing went off the radar for a long time, didn't it? Schumacher in the rain. I'm like Michael Schumacher, but three times better, mate. When the wet weather update comes in, I'm sweeping up the victories. Too late. penalty! Yay! Riot only delayed. You have merely postponed the riot.
It's my down. Turn the wheel. And if you want to wait, go a little bit faster than the others.
I request a dab. Well, you donated £1.99. I need £2 for a dab. I'm like a can girl now. I'm a can whore. £2 for a dab, man. Oh god, what's happening? This is the moment where this channel died, where you start paying for dabs. Super GT, I'm gonna be like James Charles. I'll be losing a million subs a day, even though I haven't got a million subs. The YMCA for the Porsche curves, man. That's the quickest way through there. YMCA. If I'm winning, I'll do the YMCA through the Porsche curves on the last lap. Yeah, I'll get minus subs. I'll lose so many subs, I'll get a negative amount. Then I'll get like a minus silver button. Minus gold play button. It'll be like a race between me and T-Series. T-Series will try to get 100 mil. I'm trying to get minus 100 mil. It'll be a race to who can get to which one first. All right, here we go. Quite a long way down the order. A lot of Mustangs in there. People are opting for the Mustang.
Honestly, what the f*** are we doing here?
Foster, R4M Pornhub. Yeah, I'll go with that, mate. 100% agree. Could be a cardboard play button. They just draw blood and just like, right, here's your play button, like a crappy message in blood, sweat. They spit on it, there you go. When do I go to Spa? 24th of May, so next week. It's actually next
week. Honestly, what
Thursday
are we doing?
Next week.
Racing or Pinkman?
I cannot wait. Hollander, will you see the Schumacher movie that will appear this year in Germany? Yeah, I mean, yeah, I heard, yeah, they're making a documentary on Michael Schumacher, which I'll be very interested to watch. Yeah, I'll definitely tune into that, definitely. Thank you very much, Hollander. But yeah, they're coming out with a Schumacher documentary slash film. I don't know, it's a documentary, but a film anyway, like later this year. I'm very interested, so yeah. I'd rather watch a Super GT documentary. The rise of Super GT. The subsequent fall, aka James Charles, in James Charles fashion. Right, third time doing this race. Let's see if the Ford GT works. It looks like the Mustang is a very popular choice. The thing about it is just very easy to drive. It's the easiest car to drive, I think. Super GT sob documentary. I think Netflix would explode if they made that. Netflix wouldn't be able to cope with the demands of so many viewers. I would crash Netflix. Look at that McLaren go up there. Things are rocket. Ugh. Still need to get better at that corner. One of my slower corners. Turt rouge. Luckily I'm in the slipstream though, so I'm happy. Somewhat. Oh, what's happened there? Wasn't watching. Toe-to-toe with Momos. Uh-oh. At least you get penalties. Goodbye. Oh! I boosted him there. I didn't lose any speed, but I hit him. I should have not taken that risk, really. He's still there. Right, let's go, Tommy. Tow me along, mate. It's my best shot. Just push him along because he's got a quicker car in a straight line. Oh, has he? Look at this. 180 miles an hour. Gaining on third and fourth, I can't quite tell. I will go for a move here though. He should be quite weak through this section. Don't want to be stuck behind him. As I say that, I'm really slow. He's following me perfectly. Is he going for it? No. Nothing I can do. I just need to qualify. I need to set a better lap. He's going to come flying past here. I'm not going to fight him. Look at that thing go. To work in little pairs here. Not good for the. With the chicanes are not very good. That McLaren's actually really planted. More third and fourth. They're still fighting. That thing is so planted through the corners. We are gaining on third and fourth, but we're running out of time. Oh, I fear that might be a penalty, yes. Oh my god. And it was for him as well. We won them. We both got penalties. I'm not on them anymore. McLaren is. Penalty. That'd be a fifth. Fourth. What happened there? Someone else get a penalty. Wi-Fi password. Big penalty. Okay. I'll take a fourth. I will take a fourth. Yeah, that was struggling a little bit there. I think the Mustang... The thing about it, it's a good car, but it's just on the straights, it's really hard to overtake the McLaren or the Ford, the GT, if you're in the Mustang. That's the problem. Because the top end is so good on those cars. Race A, yeah, I'll do that at. When's the next
okay,
one?
Okay, I had a look next on the internet, and this was on it. Whoa!
What do you call a Ford Fiesta that run out of gas? Ford Siesta. I'll laugh one day. Cheers, Hyper. So the winning car is the McLaren. I think that was the best way to have any chance in that race. We had to work together, bump draft, even if it kills your sportsmanship rating, or just slipstream past each other. That's all we could do, really. Okay, so...
Let's qualify for this. The 8-2. Go on, and let's see what this is all about. Just use a Group 1 car, help you be faster. Mate, that is a really good idea. I'll do that next time. I don't know why I didn't think of that. Really clever. Do it for James Charles. In the name of James Charles, I sentence you to be sent to the realm. God, look at this.
Felipe, baby, stay cool. We're bringing you the white visor. Stay cool. We're in a good position.
Well, I'd love to say I know what you mean, but I have no idea what this is a reference to, so I don't know what happened if Roxanne found the message in the bottom. Hell yeah, those dials. It's like a floaty boat. Oh my god, look how wide you can go. Was in a different postcode there. It wasn't even at Grand Hatch anymore. Look, even the replay camera can't the replay camera can't even see him, he's that far out. Where is it? Oh, there he is. It's a yoke, mate. It's a yoke. Go on then, let's qualify for this silly race, shall we? Schwartz. Minimize gear shifts, yeah. See often in these road cars, especially the classic ones. Daily race A is always lame. Pretty much true, yeah. I always do one on these live streams. I always try and do it once. I never particularly like doing it. I normally avoid it at all costs. Righty, let's have a go then. Does this car have an overtake button? Yeah, it's got DRS as well. And nitrous oxide, obviously. Full on nitrous oxide, too fast, too furious style. Right by a slight to the front. Let's try that. Oh my god, look at the body roll there. Don't want to shift out. Don't want to shift up here. It's not even going to reach the limiter anyway. Oh, okay. That's not quite what I wanted to do. No penalty though, so I'll take it. Oh boy, I hate these races. I'm sure they hate me too. It's actually got really good front end response. It turns in very quickly. Thank you to the boys back at the Porsche factory for really sorting out the front end. Look at that ghost car, it's got no driver. That really is a ghost car. See ya! Then you have to wait an eternity to get back on the power down this long straight. Well, we get under a minute, surely. Holy moly! Not like that, we won't. Right, back out there. This is my home circuit, it is, yeah. I live about half an hour from this track. That's no excuses. I should be number one. Be number one! Why do I hate it? Well, it's just the cars aren't fun to drive. That's about it. I mean, the racing can be very close. I like that, but I just don't enjoy driving the cars. Just clunky. If you let that bounce off that limiter, kills you. Ghost. Very difficult to really hook it all up. Let's try it all the way to the front. Better. Come on, there we go, beating the ghost.
Just lie down, turn the wheel, and if you want to win, go a little bit faster than all the others.
boom. Sub 1 minute. Zero Striker, hello. Thank you very much, mate. Oh, look at that sideways action, hell yeah. Go way quicker because I hit the gravel there, look.
Slide down, turn the wheel, and if you want to win, go a little bit faster than all the others.
Cheers, mate. Looks like an old man something. Thank you for the tenner, man. Ah, killed all my momentum there. Really hard striking a lap in one go altogether. I can definitely beat it though because I've messed up this first corner. There we go. Look at that. Come on. Slide, it just kills your momentum so much. 3 temps off though. Still 3 temps. I took this corner so, this last turn, took it so well on the ghost lap. I don't think I can do that again. Look at that. I just lose like 3 temps. I took it so perfectly. Yeah, let's just try third gear only on the last turn.
I always want to start by saying big thank you to all this crowd. I mean, you guys have been amazing.
Being washed up, thank you very much, mate. Oh god, drifted too much. Let's look at the comparison then. I'll stay in third gear this time.
Get in there, Lewis. Miracles do happen, mate.
On the power really early. You lose a bit here, but then I won't have to do a gear shift. Yeah, probably do gain. Gain overall.
I think Ericsson hit us.
Thank you, HyperBlue. That's a penalty. That go 4 temps quicker. Oh, this lap won't count, and that's really frustrating. Okay, I know what to do now, though. Well, let's just retry because I have to serve that penalty. Thank you, Skyline. I'll see you next time, mate. Don't shift that corner. I've got pretty much one attempt here. Get it right. going to beat it. They're going to be 59.6, 59.5. I'll take that. 59.4. Let's see what the leaderboard times were. The problem, yeah, and the problem as well with race A is road cars are normally really bad for overtaking because everyone's exactly the same. It's just really hard to overtake people. Top 10 starts, 58.2. Jesus, have a second quicker. I really want to see a video about you racing in a real supporter car one day. Hopefully, man, one day, that'd be the dream. Get to race cars, that'd be awesome. Weak slipstream, yeah, I mean, okay, if weak slipstream's on, then that'll help. But if it's on real, then there's no chance. Okay, where are we? Fourth on the grid. I think that lap was okay. I could still go quicker, still go maybe 59, low 59, but would have only possibly got one more position. Jimmy's off to Denmark to do some Audi driving a TCR car. That's awesome. I'm off to London to do some go-karting and crash team racing. That's arguably better. No, it's definitely better. Always a risk to go three people like that. Ooh. So who's watched the Game of Thrones episode 5 then? I'm not going to say anything, but my god. My god, man. Crazy episode. That's it. Go and watch it. What's Jimmy Broadbent like in real life? Seems like he would be a huge jerk. What makes you think that? I mean, he's fine. I've met him. I met him twice. He's a very good guy. No alcohol tonight. I haven't got any, actually. I've run out. All I've got is water. I'm a good boy. This is a full start check. No. Oh god, that gear change. The longest thing. Ah, couldn't cut back on him. They're all coming at me now. Come on. Bird. Let's get in that slipstream if it's on weak. Don't you dare, mate. Six laps of this. So slidey.
second made a mistake. There's a really difficult corner to take in this car. Oh God. Lift right off there. And the guy in fourth called Punt Tony. Luckily, I'm not called Tony, so he doesn't have to punt me. Kind of in no man's land, I can't really catch up. They're not really fighting. This is the problem. This is what I was saying about race A. Normally, in road cars in this game, it's really hard to overtake. You kind of, I've seen an FIA race as well, like everyone just sells into an order in a line and then no one can do anything. Has anyone moved positions? I've gone up a few. Well, I've gone up one. It got a bit messy at the start. Oh, got fastest lap. Oh, 4M's coming for ya. Don't bottle it. Wait, that was quicker than my qualifying lap. Give me slipstream. Yes, I've got it, I think. Oh, here we go. It's on now, boy. What you got? Come on, Frenchie, he's bottled it. Pick a line, boy. Kept it. But yeah, just push me off the freaking track. Here is done. Signed, sealed, and delivered by R4M Shadow GT with the full send. Express delivery. And that's how you get into R4M. Indy food parts. Hell yeah. That's how you go full send. That is how you go full send. Get in there, Steve.
Fantastic drive, mate. Miracles do happen. The annoying thing is about race A is that you just miss race B. We've missed it by like a minute. It's really annoying. Literally the worst thing in the world. Nothing worse. Look at that. You just miss it. But I do need to improve my qualifying time anyway, so let's... Who's number one now? McLaren. CA rated. Okay then, let's have a look at this. British World Ramming Championship. I'll be the champion of that. I'll be the 10-time back-to-back champion. Untouchable. Mehmet, see you next time, mate. Thanks for tuning in. It's a legit lap. Let's have a look. Let's analyse. See what he's doing. I don't know. I'm guessing, yeah, the McLaren might, I think, once it all settles down and people can decide which is the best car, I think the McLaren might be the better one, but we'll see. Maybe Thomas and Castor will come back with the Huracan. Let's take a look at this then. Waiting for the first total banner. Two wheels on the yellow, two wheels there, two wheels there. On the curb still. I think about this car, it's actually surprisingly planted. It's actually got good grip. It doesn't particularly turn sharply, but it's just very solid. Okay, there. And go. I think we've got two on the blue and yellow. Okay, I think here you can go onto the blue and yellow as long as you're back. As long as two wheels are on the track by the end of the curve, then you're okay, I think. Yeah,
so. Felipe, baby, stay cool. We're bringing you the white visor. Stay cool. We're in a good
Alexandra.
Position.
Alexandra. Which part of the UK are you from? I'm southeast, so very close to London. I'm a southerner. I'm a dirty southerner. There's the brake then. Normally I'm looking for that. There's a 200 board there, and then you've got that brake in the barrier on the left. Started to brake yet. Pretty much there. Oh, slid it in there beautifully. That's what she said. Okay. Right there. Next one, 100 board just before. We're all over there. Not on that bit. A little bit over there. Boom, 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 second gear, go over that curb, and you can use all of that there, okay. Kind of avoid that curve, you don't really want to go any more than that curve. Second gear, all the way out. Right here. Second. A little bit wide, but still good. Use all of the run out, all of the run off there. This is the hard bit then. Let's see how he does the Porsche curves. Probably by doing the YMCA, that's obviously the fastest way. Hooked up, nice and patient on the throttle. Up wide. I mean, this section is just about patience in this car. Up nice and open. Oh wow, okay, you can go really low with that curb there. You can go that far as long as you've got two on the curb. He's bloody hell right on the edge. There's a break here. No, I think it's just before that. Started to break. Yeah, just before that point on the ground. I need to work out the track what it's like for this. What can you do here then? I don't think I was getting this as I could. On the red and blue and yellow. Okay, and he's completely off beyond the line, but that's what you can do. It used to be a case that you touch that red thing and you get a big red penalty, but okay, so we'll get you in a second. All the way out. And again, beyond the line, but we'll let you do. Okay. So that's the limit. We know what it is now. Let's try and emulate that. Where's Baron? Red thing has never been an auto pen. I swear. I guess not necessarily just the red thing then, maybe a bit further, but I do remember having a race where someone got a penalty instantly because they cut that. Maybe not the red, but maybe a bit further then. Right, got enough time for maybe four laps? Yeah, probably more like three. Cut that bit more. I think if I can just get to 55s, I think that'll be good. Because I was starting like 9th or 10th in those races, it's way too far back. Maybe starting at least 4th or 5th. Or stand any chance of winning. This is the McLaren F1 GTR. It was added, when was this added? A couple of months ago? Pretty sure it's got the best top end. Got the highest top speed of all the Group 3 cars, which is why it works around here. Are there any 24-hour races in this game? Well, in Gran Turismo. In the old Gran Turismos, yes, but not in this one. Well, you can do a 200 lap race around the Nordschleife, which would be longer than 24 hours if you wanted to. good. Comes the hard bit. Need to cut that a little bit more. Quite a lot more. Was that exactly the same as my PB? It was very close. Please don't be a penalty. Oh, that was very close. I think I'm safe. It was exactly the same. Okay, I thought it was. Madness. When have you ever seen that? Look at this, 7 tenths up, come on. What's the record? The record, 53.9. So I'm still a long way off of that. Quarters of a second still. Oh god, horrible exit. Now I'm going to lose time all the way down this straight. Tiny bit too late on the brakes. Temps up now. There's definitely time to be gained in the Porsche curves. Thank you. Oh, boom. 54. What a lap. It's 1 second off the world record. And that was with mistakes as well. Second off, I'm normally aiming for 1 second off the world record, and I'm 1 second off. And this is a much longer track, albeit with not so many corners. Oh, there we go. Well, not with, what's the right word? So there's more corners, it's a long track, but there's less density of corners. I'm 1 second, the top is 53.9, so I'm 1 second off. Oh my god. Let's have a look. Let's bank it, hell yeah. 1 second slower as well. Oh god, it's not a 53.9, sorry. I thought it was 53.9. Not that close then. There's a big spread though, look at that. It's like 1.5 seconds in the top 10. That's a really big split. Still wait, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6 different cars in there still. I think the McLaren will come out on top eventually. Everyone. Not quite quicker than Calster. Still a second quicker. That was a good lap though, 54.9. Now, what's the top 10? Yeah, I'm 3 tenths away from top 10. And I could have. To be fair, I could do that if I hooked it all up. Come to Dubai soon. Thank you very much, mate. I would like to go there one day. I've always been intrigued by Dubai. I've never been. I'll be there soon just for you, mate. It was a good lap, well, I'm pretty pleased with it. I could still go quicker, but probably not much more than a mid 54. Yeah, I lost, oh god. Yeah, I lost quite a lot of time. I can't remember the name of the turn, but the one at the very end of the straight, the 90 degree right hander. Will I ever go to lift here? Only if a sim lets me go.
this corner. And again, look, yeah, definitely need to brake earlier than that. But I'm happy with the 54.9. Let's see where that puts us on the grid. I think that might be... that might be pole. I mean, I think in the last two races, that would have been pole, I think.
I think so.
Thank you, Ray. The 99 cents. There we go, pole position. Halbstark. He loves to use something weird. He's in the Peugeot. We'll see how that thing is. Actually, I heard it's quite good in a straight line. We'll see. Right, if I had kept my 56, I would have been about 7th or 8th. I would have been 8th by time. Complete that 54.9, I'll take that. Good evening, TR The Flash. It's been a long time. Hope you all as well. Good to see you. Good straight line equals poor rear grip. Choose the tyres. Yeah, I don't know. This car feels alright. It feels pretty planted, and there is no tyre wear, so chewing tyres isn't a thing, really. Position. But what are they driving? The Peugeot, Mustang, McLaren, Mustang, McLaren, Mustang, McLaren, McLaren, Super. DR. Someone's in the R8. Someone's in the Beetle. Ripperoni probably lapped that person. Watch them win now. Now that I've said that. At least by being at the front on pole, you get the benefit of not being on the bloody chicane at the start. That's a bonus. What gear do you launch in? No, we'll find out. Probably second from a rolling start. Top one and first and second are good for the start again. Yeah. Look at that gap though. Look at that gap. I'm already like a second ahead.
Get in there, Lewis.
The chicane just seemed to mess the order up with the gaps. Thank you, Voldy.
Get in there, Lewis. Miracles do happen, mate.
I was so close to losing. Oh, for God's sake. Well, there's the bottle. Thank you, Bobby B and CMCG. That Peugeot is quick, it's keeping up. I'm not gaining on it.
Jesus, man. What was that all about? Jeez Louise. That was a good punt, to be fair. I could sign that guy up to R4M. I've seen enough. You're in, mate. Look at that thing go. I'm going for it, though. It looked like they were going together there. Nine temps. Don't know how Stark did there. Looked like, I think he might have got loose on the curb or something. He lost loads of time and they were sort of angled against each other. My slipstream. That mistake is, it could be costly because now we can go past. Try again, Buster. Come back at him now. got to be now. Still do this. Oh no. Oh god. Messed it right up at the end. Look at that penalty, because that was a bit weird. Because there was contact as well, I was pushed into that. Unless it was the one, I think it was the, it wasn't the final chicane, it was the one before it. It must have been that. Must have been that bit. I shouldn't have given him a chance anyway, because that mistake at the end of the first lap, that's what did it really. Where did I start? I started on pole. So I've lost out there. It was a good race though, it was a good battle. It's very tactical, you're just going back past each other all the time. Let's have a look. My library. One pixel beyond the line. Look. Let's see how it was, how it went down. Yeah, I could have. That's the thing, I could have cut the chicane after he tapped me, got him a penalty. But I didn't think quick enough. Remember when I said Lambo on sub? Yeah, that happened. You'll be back, mate. You're always here. You love it, really. Love it, really, mate. Circuit de la Sarf, come on. Get loaded. I want to see what happened with Halbstark as well. Oh, I gotta watch this stupid intro. Do you do fitness training for kart racing? I mean, I do fitness, I go to the gym. It's not necessarily just for karting, but I do it. I go to the gym just to keep in shape in general, and it helps in karting. So, yes, I guess. Where that mega punt came in. I'd love to know what penalty he got for that. Probably nothing. Oh, that's what happened. And he got annoyed with it. Oh, then he went wide. Halbstark, man. Yeah, that was a dodgy move. Yeah, pull it. That's not good. I looked behind briefly now. I could see him just like turning across. I wonder what was going on. I thought he just lost it on the curb. No. This. Yeah, that's the mistake I've done it. I was like 1.3 seconds ahead here. This mistake. I lost like half a second. It was literally. I thought this was a decent move. I went a little bit too wide. Covered the inside, went to the left. I just went, oh, a little bit too hot. And that's where I got a penalty. Oh my God, look how close that was. I did go over, but like, oh, it's such a tiny amount. It was like, oh my. Honestly, it's like as close as it could possibly be. That was literally the pixel over the line. That's where I got the 0.5. Without that, I would have won, presumably. Ahead by this point. Have a look then. Penalty. Up at the middle, so he couldn't really go anywhere. And I thought I kept it in. I think. I swear you're allowed two wheels on the curb. I guess. Wait. Yes, just before I hit the curb, I was four wheels out. You can go four wheels onto the curb, I guess. Maybe like there, I don't know. Or there, I'm like four wheels beyond the line. And then I get on the curb, like 1 millimeter later. I should have cut the corner then. Would have got him a penalty. Oh well. That's how it went down. Four wheels over the white line. Yeah, but if you watch the replay of the top time, it goes four wheels over the white line on the curb. So you can do the curb, all four wheels beyond the line, but it's just four wheels beyond the line before the curb, I think. The game's frozen now. It's given up. Oh, come on. Race is about to start. I made a lot of mistakes there anyway, but I always like to just know why you got a penalty. A lot of the time you can't work it out because the game being an idiot, but I did go wide there. It's such fine margins, like just a tiny bit wide. Ah, got yourself. Come on, hurry up. Mr. Nightmare, good luck for your GCSE, mate. Should be revising, shouldn't be watching me. Oh, 17 seconds, we're good. What was the other car? Let's please Calster, shall we? Let's use the Lambo. I'm going to lose, but I've done no practice. Okay, can't qualify. Member has a uni exam tomorrow. Everyone doing their exams and they're watching me. You should be revising and then sleeping. I'm just so glad I don't have to do exams anymore. I hated them. I hate how like a year of learning can come down to one little 2-hour test. And you can mess it up. And it doesn't always, I don't know, an exam doesn't always. I don't know, truly show your knowledge. Maybe you do know things, but you can't quite put it into words on the paper. But it is what it is. Although to be fair, I normally got decent. I've got 5 A's at GCSE. I'll take that. Have you done race C? Yes, I have. I've done it once. Finished second.
Side fourth. No, wait. Well, finished second, side fourth, I think. Got a 5-second penalty for nothing. But, Autopolis in the Super Formula. I think this is the interesting race this week because of the mix of cars. I still can't quite work out which is the best car. It's obviously going to be the Huracan. Exams are awful. GCSEs are mostly going to be exam-based going forward. Yeah, because I would say enjoy, but I used to do well on the coursework. I much prefer coursework to exams. Okay, I'm going to get about 30 seconds to drive this car. Good start. Just wants to slide all the time. There's almost no coursework these days, yeah. I used to not mind the coursework too much. Well, it depends on the subject, because I remember like technology, design and technology, the coursework was just... That was, to be fair, in that subject it was pretty much all coursework. We had to like do a project and it was like one piece of year-long coursework. One, but see what happens. I'm using an unfamiliar car and a one I don't normally like driving. So you have to learn how to slide this car, to drive it well. Not slide it, but like work with the way that it turns is just really weird. That Peugeot's actually very quick. Way later than that. Not sure there's much I can do when the McLaren gets up to me. This car, I hate it. Oh no.
I thought I braked too early anyway. Obviously not. My tip is just to never use a car you haven't practiced with it. Especially if it's this car. And was off. Somehow in sixth. This car, I can't express how much I don't like driving it. It's awful. Well, it's not awful, it's just really difficult. And if you can't drive it, it's obviously got loads of potential, but it's just very difficult to get right. It's very hard to really control the speed, control the sliding through the corners. You kind of have to, in a way, you almost have to... Oh, God. In a way, you almost have to use the drifting. So you get on the power early and use the slide a little bit, but... Then.
Oh, God. Oh, give up with this stupid car. Oh. Never driving that thing again. You've broken a man, you have. I just wanted to, rage quit from about the second corner. Don't cut the first chicane. The thing is, it's like, to get the best line, to get the best time, you have to. It just, it unsettles the car, but like, if you don't do it, you're just going to lose time.
Have a look on the internet,
you might as well just try.
This was on it. Whoa!
I was never going to win that anyway. Reminder that you are a bad driver. Another reminder that you've got bad grammar. But yeah, it's true. I bottled that. I think it's quite clear that in certain cars I'm a lot worse than in others. It's definitely true. So I mean, I think it's just when there's a lot more grip, I'm a lot better. That one, it just felt really weird, felt really off. Hey. Well, thank you once again, Brandon. Thanks for tuning in for my daily reminder. Watch my own video on how to improve. Yeah, I think I need to do that, actually. That's a good idea. Alright. Oh, Ian Callum joins. Oh, read that. Oh, get that car out of my sight.
Okay, I had a look on the internet and this was on it. Whoa!
Reminder that I'm bad at grammar, but you're a bad driver. You still got your grammar wrong, come on. Change it. You could have changed it there. That was your chance. Here's Brandon. That is a beautiful car. I love that livery. Well, even though it's a Bentley livery, but who cares? Okay. There we go. We're going to wrap this one up. Much love as always, everyone. I'm going to London tomorrow to play Crash Team Racing, of all games. I'll put some stuff up on Instagram, on Twitter, if you want to have a look. And then see what we can do about getting a video for that. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the stream. And just a reminder to not use the Huracan, because it's absolutely awful. Shocking car. Should just be burnt in a fire and never be seen again. Okay, everyone, good evening, good morning, good night, whatever it may be. Take care till next time. I'll see you in the next video tomorrow.